Next up, health news. If your trick-or-treaters bring home black licorice, should you be concerned? Health experts have long warned that eating too much of the candy can cause serious health problems.
I'm scratching my head about this. Nutritionist Shari Bukvar is here, as opposed to red licorice?
Which there's something about black that is specific.
It's black licorice. There's something called glycyrrhizin, which is in... Well, let me start by saying, in most commercial products, it's not a concern.
Because it's not real black licorice anyway.
Correct.
But the old school,
that
those like wheels and all those sort of things.
Yes.
Right.
So traditionally, the way it was made years ago, with this chemical that's in it, it can be detrimental to the heart. It can potassium levels can drop. It can increase blood pressure. Cause congestive heart failure, but what it's made with now are either artificial ingredients.
We're so far removed from the real thing.
Yeah, I mean, there are some that are made with a little bit of licorice extract, but the amount is so negligible that it's not an amount for concern. The only thing is that for people who are eating it every day, 2 ounces or more, if you're over 40, then you want to be careful. Well, people do have their things.
Somebody's
that we do,
doing something everywhere,
if someone's out there and they're over 40 eating more than 2 ounces a day every day.
Gotcha.
But as with everything else, always switch
it up. Rest assured, the lab-created licorice that's a different color than black is better for you.
Right, there you go.
As far as this concern.
We're splitting hairs there, but it's a real thing.
Sugar. But from that standpoint, it's likely not a concern.
All right, that's wild. Thank you. Experts calling for more research on artificial sweeteners and the impact they have on kids. Yeah, this is
the more we learn about this stuff, the scarier it is. It's wild.
So I'm really happy that the American Academy of Pediatrics is pushing for this. We don't know how much of different artificial sweeteners are in products. You see it on the ingredient list, but you don't, if you think about it, you put, let's just say, aspartame in your tea or your coffee, you know you're putting one packet in. But if you look at products in the market, whether it's yogurts or there's a lot of surprises.
They'll tell you it's sweetened with, but they won't say how much.
Right, or you look at the ingredient list, sometimes there's two artificial sweeteners. How do you make that comparison? Does this, and by the way, there are a lot of foods out there that you don't even realize there are artificial sweeteners in. Breads, English muffins.
Are they required to tell you though?
Well, it does. It says it does. It's not on the front of the package, but it is on the ingredient list.
Sneaky in there that you don't pay attention to.
Right,
And then, I don't know, the people make the assumption that orange juice that has 50% less sugar, you got to look at the ingredient list.
Artificial
sweeteners.
Yeah,
so anything... Most products, not all, but most products that say low sugar or reduced sugar or less sugar, always look at that ingredient list. But again, that's the problem, is we still don't know how much. So now that we are starting to see added sugars, so you know how much added sugar, I'd like to start seeing, as does the American Academy of Pediatrics, you want to see how much, how many grams of artificial sweetener are in it, and specific to the type. So as parents, we can see, and I think for everybody, it's not just for parents and children,
agreed,
for everyone.
Yes.
We don't know the long-term health effects of artificial sweeteners, whether it's on health or obesity, diabetes. It would be nice so we can make that, and as a practitioner, I would better be able to make that recommendation for X amount of artificial sweeteners a day.
Right.
That if you're gonna have it, limit it to a certain amount, and then somebody can look at a nutrition facts label and make that judgment call as to what's worth it for them.
Makes sense.
Good point.
All right, thank you.